My name is Lanre Dasilva. I'm an occupation fashion designer. Lanre Dasilva, self-named.
How are you finding the event so far?
Very, I've been able to learn quite a bit from those I saw alongside my own panelists. It was really nice. You know, Access Bank is doing something quite, it's good to know sometimes how people are more innovative. And that's where I think Nigeria needs to go to, because we have that intention of sort of following up with other people. So it's good knowledge.
Even though you didn't speak for that long, but you did give us like a deep insight into Nigerian fashion industry, and you've been here for 10 years. What would you say the innovation of technology has been like in the industry?
The innovation has been really good. We've had to, at the end of the day, when you look at fashion and related to innovation, you have to remember that things that you've met on ground already, and then you introduce it to your own country. Like when I came back home and I decided I wanted to do Victorian era dressing, people were not comfortable with it. In fact, people had said, "Oh, Larry, are you sure this is what you want to do?" And I said, "You know what? I'll just do it maybe some few clients and see how it goes." And luckily for me today, I think the Nigerian fashion industry has really grown. Nigerian men are more confident. That's very important, because when you wear something and you walk into a room and it's something that nobody else has, you have to walk in elegantly and you have to own your own. And that's something we've grown to appreciate. And you know, with the growth of social media, Instagram, everybody wants to post, everyone wants to look good. So it's so good for the fashion industry.
Yeah. Okay, talking about social media, how would you say social media and digital media have helped build fashion in Nigeria?
Huge. I know someone that doesn't have any store or anything, started making some nice things on Instagram and she's selling. You know, that's the extent to which the Instagram, social media, digital marketing has come. It brings the consumer and the supplier together as one. There is good communication. Communication is key. You target your audience. You know what we like to say. You immediately know who wants to buy. They will immediately tell you, "Larry, I like this dress," on Instagram. There are direct messages. It's amazing. I can't even tell you more. You know what they don't like as well. You know, so if you put something up and no one's really saying anything, then, you know, like, this one, maybe you should not produce so much. You know, so it's a good interacting system.
So for you, let's talk about you as a brand. 10 years and you're still going strong. How have you been able to remain a leader, seeing as in this era of social media there's so many young designers cropping up and pushing themselves? Even they have more of an advantage than you did when you started. How have you stayed a leader?
Well, I really thank God that, I have all these lovely young designers, very, very creative, and they all sort of come, aspire, and want to know how I've been able to sustain myself in the industry. So I think that's also an added advantage to myself. And also, this is something that I have very great passion for. So I consistently, and it has to be something you're consistent about. So every time I want to create something new, and I'm happy that the consumers are also appreciative of it. Like I mentioned earlier on, just in this interview about digital marketing, you're immediately interacting with your clients, your consumers, and you know where they are going. And even the young ones coming behind that have those much more advantage are also still trying to see what was done by us wrongly or positively and trying to correct all those things. So I think, to be honest, I thank God for the respect, and I've also been opportunities to talk in places like Dolce & Gabbana, Selfridges, Yokes. I've had international successes with Vogue Italia, the Frank Zani, Anna Wintour, Bridget Vogue. So there's a lot for you to sort of look up to and want to know, what is it about this lady? What is she doing? You know, so I think that's also been an added, it's not been just on my own, Yeah. And the Nigerian press, right now I'm talking to you, all of this sends the news about what you're doing out there. If I do the Access Brand Conference and no one gets to know, then no one's going to know I'm even doing it. But any young designer there will be like, "I would love to speak at the Access Brand Conference. This is a good thing that Larry Dasilva is doing." So all those things actually are positive values advantage to my brand.